So, I have here the DSO Quad. It's a great device, but the best thing is that it is open hardware. That means that you can write your own programs for it. However, there are only 4 application slots, and the programming environment is not so pleasant to work in. But I have something that fixes the problem. This is a PAVN interpreter for the DSO Quad. You can store the programs on the integrated 2 MB flash memory, and it has an easy scripting language style programming language for writing programs. I have also prepared a standard library for using the device. I have here the program selector, where you can see all the installed programs and select one of them. You can then use the program just like if it was native code written in C. Now I will show the installation. Just connect the USB cable and turn on the device while holding the left mouse button. Then on the computer, you must copy the hex image here. You can get it from GitHub. I have 2 copies here also. Already I will get this one. And then disconnects when the installation is complete. Then reboot into PAVN by holding down the 4th button. It shows empty screen now. So we have to copy some PAVN programs here. You can find the programs, for example, in the wiki. I will now take the servo tester as an example. Here it is. I can also copy the frequency response. I have already downloaded it. Now just reboot to show the files. They are listed here. I can start them. Here is the configuration dialog. Everything is working as it should be. Then, if you want to develop custom applications, there is also a tutorial in the Getting Started. Basically, on Windows, you have to download and install the PAVN IDE and set some settings. I have already installed it. So, and also, I have already set the compiler path in options. Let's make a simple example file, PAVN source file. I will include the console library because it allows easy printing of text. syntax is very similar to C, but it has no concept of types, so it's slightly easier to use. Then just press the compile button. It says everything completed successfully. It has compiled. I will find it wherever I saved the file. It's here, called script1amx. I will copy it to the USB disk, press refresh, and there it is, and it prints the text. So it is really simple to make programs for this platform.